Hello and welcome to the topic
Primitive Notions About Language. What are the notions about language? What are the main ideas about language? What people since generations, they have been thinking about language. So we are going to discuss about what primitive notions hold about language. What oldest opinions hold about language. And you know, these notions, these ideas are divided into two different categories, two different parts. You can say that there are two different opinions about language, about how language originated, about how language came into birth, how language came into existence. And the first is belief in divine creation. And the second is natural evolution hypothesis. Look, belief in divine creation means that there are people who believe that language is the creation of God. And the second one, natural evolution hypothesis, it says that no, language is not the creation of God. Language is an evolutionary process. So let's talk about these two different ideas, how language originated. So the first is belief in divine creation. And let's talk about this. Look, those who believe in this system, those who believe in divine creation, they believe that language is the gift of God to humans. God has given innumerable things to people. A language is one of them. The second is, according to Judeo-Christian-Islamic beliefs, Adam gave names to all living creatures. Look, those who believe that language is the divine creation, language is a gift from God to humans. And according to this belief, like Judaism, Christianity, or even Islam, they all believe that after God created Adam, then God also made Adam speak certain words to recognize the objects, to communicate. And therefore, in this sense, language is the creation of God. Then we have another point in this direction. Magical properties of language. Belief in special powers of language that help in controlling people, objects, and spirits. There are also people who believe that language has magical properties. It has special powers. If the language is not the creation of God, the language will not have the special powers of influencing others. The language has the power to control people, to control objects, to control spirits. How? Now, for example, if you know magic, if you read certain words and you can be able to control people, influence people. This special power and magical influence in language, where does it come from? How it happens? It's not by science. It's from God. Unless or until God has not given that special influence, the language cannot have that much effect upon the heart and mind of human beings. Therefore, language is the creation of God. Therefore, language comes from God. This is basically the point about those who believe in divine creation. Now we have the second group who says that no, language is not the creation of God. Language is process. Natural evolution hypothesis means that language has naturally evolved, has naturally come into existence slowly but surely. How? Let's read. It can't be proven that language is as old as humans. So, scientific thinkers, they believe that it's not necessary that when humans were created, at that point of time, the language was also created. Had that been the case, that when the human is born and the human starts speaking, then any child that is born should speak, but the child does not speak. So, it cannot be proven that language is as old as humans. It's not scientifically proved. It's almost wrong. However, wherever humans exist, language exists. Of course, language is the product of human society. Now go to the next point. At some point in their evolutionary development, humans acquired a more sophisticated brain which made language invention and learning possible. In other words, at some point in time, humans evolved a language acquisition device. Look, according to this point of view, the scientific theory believes that humans came into existence after thousands and thousands of years. Before, they behaved like apes. Then slowly they grew up. They got mature. Physically, they got the shape of human beings. After that, when the physical shape became perfect, then they had the sophisticated system of brain. After they started using brain, then they thought about using the language and inventing various other things. So they believe that during the process of human development, which took thousands and thousands of years, in this process humans got a more sophisticated brain. When the body developed, in conjunction with that, human brain also developed. Then humans started thinking that now we have the mind, we have the brain, we have the thought, we can think in a much better way. Let us make learning possible. So at that point of time, after thousands and thousands of years of evolutionary development, then this sophisticated brain made humans invent language. And it is in this process of time, humans evolved a language acquisition device, what we call LAT. So according to natural evolution hypothesis, language is not the creation of God. Why? Because language has evolved. Nothing in this world has happened abruptly and suddenly and immediately. Humans have struggled hard and then certain things have developed. Language is like any other things which human has invented. So, in my opinion, both the ideas about the birth of language seem credible. If you have the logic from the religious point of view, you will say that no, language is the creation of God. Because if language is not the creation of God, then language could not have magical special powers of influencing others. At another point of time, when we talk about scientific system or natural evolution hypothesis, we come to believe that no, language is not the creation of God. Of course, everything is created by God in that way, but language is not the direct creation of God. God did not send any book of language directly on the earth and told people, look, you read the language. Had that been the case, we all could have spoken the same language. But we have different languages in different societies. It means that societies have made language possible. The need of the society has made the language possible. So in that way, natural evolution hypothesis seems very logical. Anyway, there are two different opinions. It depends upon you, upon your personal scientific spirit, which way you go. My advice, whatever ideas you stick to, try to defend your arguments from that perspective. That makes sense and that looks credible. Okay.